honestly, like I said, you damn near have to make reservations to McDonald's. You know what I'm saying? You got to wear this mask. You got everybody's acting a fool. The restaurants can't have over 25% capacity. Literally, just to give you some idea, around the time of my anniversary, maybe it was a week ago, on the 19th, time is fleeting, and we wanted to go out to dinner. And I wasn't aware of it was that deep. So I'm going, calling around. Everywhere's full. You look to make reservations. The next days after that, you couldn't get nothing to like night, like almost to when they're closing. You literally have to do this stuff weeks in advance. So, I mean, how would you date during the pandemic? I'm guessing online would be one. So are we Zooming dating? Like, are we flashing titties over Zoom? What we doing?
Not Zooming. not flashing. Nothing like that. I think it slowed down. I think online dating went up, but that in-person dating, like that full connection, it slowed down tremendously. And I think I put some dating on hold. I didn't really go too far. A couple of phone calls, and it's nothing that you can really do. And I mean, and I'm not trying to have you all shacked up in my house, and, you know, and
don't bring that damn COVID.
You didn't know if they had COVID, and, you know, just it's risky. So it's kind of dead in my backyard.
You know what? Honestly, I feel like COVID would be the least of my concerns, to be honest with you. I'm more worried about herpes. AIDS,
preach,
like stuff like that. Like that stuff did not go away.
Unwanted child,
unwanted sex.
Exactly.
Sex and dating is totally two different things.
It is, but and I'm glad.
You said how?
No, it ain't.
Well, because you just went into your anniversary, so you know, we're talking about just going out to dinner. We not even yet going to the bedroom yet.
Well, you know what? Some of us though,
yeah, but
you got class. You date a certain way. Some of us is on the first night. You know, yeah. I mean, not me, of course, but you know, that's what they doing. You know, so
WAP.
They passing their WAP out, honey. They spreading it around.
So at the beginning of the pandemic, when they scared everybody and said, "Hey, you know, people dropping like flies," of course everybody tightened up. You know, naturally, you know, not going out, not having company, and all that. But I'm sure people got tired after a while.
And they started bending
a little bit more. You know what? Maybe you can come over for a minute, you know. Wear a mask, you know what I'm saying?
Wear a mask. What?
Like the risk is not that high. Yeah.
You know, but no, dating during the pandemic has definitely been a little more challenging, but as me personally, who not really that confident in the truth about this whole pandemic thing, we talked about that on another show.
Yeah.
It really didn't change much for me personally.
Okay.
Of course, things closed down, so I wasn't able to get out like I'm usually am, you know, go have a drink with a friend or whatever the case may be. But outside of me not being able to go places, just the dating part really didn't change much for me. I mean, of course, people were scared to, you know, go around people, but it didn't change in my perspective, you know.
I want to know, is anybody checking folks' temperature at the door?
That's what I want to know.
Dating familiarity, though. I want to know who dating new people.
If you coming over, because like you said, everything is close. Well, was. So at some point we're dating. Let's say we're talking on the phone or we're doing these little Zooms.
How you finding these people?
Huh?
How you finding these people if we're not going nowhere? That's what I want to know. Like, where are we finding said people?
Yes,
what I would like to know.
I need y'all to call in.
I think